So what? So I'm going to write a table here. So I had y prime of 0, for example. And what did I get for y sub 3, which is approximately equal to the value of y sub 9? This is what I got. When I chose y prime of 0 equal to 4, I got 1548. That's what I got as the value of y sub 3, which is far away from 0. But then when I chose it to be minus 24, I got minus 216. So can I somehow be able to figure out what should I choose for y prime of 0 so that this thing turns out to be 0, or close to 0, as I should say? So if I use interpolation technique to be able to figure out, hey, what value of y prime of 0 should I choose so that I get 0 for y sub 3? So the way I'm going to do it, I'm going to, let's suppose, call this to be p sub 0. I'm going to call this p sub 1. I'm going to call this q sub 0. I'm going to call this q sub 1. I'm just writing this down just for interpolation purposes. So this function I'm going to call p, and this function I'm going to call q. So if p and q, so what that means, that p is equal to p naught plus p1 minus p naught divided by q1 minus q naught times q minus q naught. This is just an equation of a straight line between q being between q naught and q1. So this is just an equation of a straight line. And if I'm going to write p in terms of q, what I'm going to get, p is p naught, which is 4, plus p1 minus p naught, which is 24, minus 4, divided by minus 24, divided by 4. P1 is minus 24. And then q1 is minus 216, and q naught is 1548, times q minus q naught, which is 1548. And what am I looking for? I'm looking for a value where q becomes 0. Right? I'm looking for a value where q becomes, where y sub 3 becomes 0. So I'm going to just put q equal to 0, and this value turns out to be minus 20.57. So what I'm trying to say is that rather than choosing another guess between 4 and minus 24, let's suppose, because you can very well see that, hey, from somewhere between 4 and minus 24, most probably this y sub 3 is going to become 0. We use interpolation, linear interpolation technique, to be able to come up with the guess which will maybe bring us closer to the value of y sub 3 being equal to 0. So based on this, this is what happens. Now I'm going to choose y sub, I'm going to choose y prime of 0. I'm going to choose y prime of 0. So again, I'm going to say choose. I'm going to choose y prime of 0 to be equal to 20.57. So when I do that, this is what I get. Again, you're going to use Euler's method. So go through the steps of Euler's method. So you're going to go through the steps of the Euler's method, and this is what you're going to obtain for different values of x, different values of y and z. So it's I, this is x, this is y, this is z. So when I is 0, of course x is 0, y is 0, and z is minus 20.57, which is the initial slope. Then when I choose I equal to 1, I get x equal to 3, and we get this to be minus 61.7, and this one turns out to be minus 20.57. Then at 2, the value of x is 6, I get minus 123.42, and here I get 41.17. And when I choose I equal to 3, I get x equal to 9, and I get 0.09. So you can very well see that now y sub 3, which you are getting here, the y sub 3, you're getting it as minus 0.09, which is this number, which is approximately equal to y sub 9, approximately y sub 9. So you are finding out that this number is now getting close to 0. Now, if you would have chosen more significant digits, you will get a much, much smaller number here, almost close to 0. So the reason why you're getting not exactly 0 is because I didn't choose, I chose only 4 or 5 significant digits while I was doing these calculations. But you'll find out that, hey, you will get almost close to 0. So that becomes the solution then. So basically, this is your solution to the boundary value problem, that at x equal to 0, the value of y is 0. At x equal to 3, this is the value of y. At x equal to 6, this is the value of y. And at x equal to 9, the value is approximately 0, because that's the boundary condition which is given to you. So you have used the initial value problem to solve a boundary value problem. And if you are interested in finding out the slopes of y, you also have those numbers which you can find also. So that's how this shooting method works. And what I would like you to do as homework is the following. Does the value of y, 3, get close to 0 on the first try? So on the first try of using the linear interpolant, we don't have to do any more hit and trial. Does the value of y is 3 get close to 0 on the first try, because the example is a linear ordinary differential equation? So go ahead and see if you can answer that question. What you can do is you can try to solve, or try to use this method. With a nonlinear ODE, now, the reason why I'm saying that try this method with a nonlinear ODE example is because then you can appreciate that, hey, does are you going to get the value y of 3 or the value at the end boundary condition to be same as what the applied boundary condition is if you're going to solve a nonlinear ordinary differential equation. The third one is compare the values with exact solution. So because we are taking h equal to 3, that means that the kind of answers you are getting are not exact. We're using a shooting method to be able to solve a boundary value problem, but still it's a numerical scheme. So I would like you to compare the values with the exact solution. And number four is repeat the example. Repeat the example using Runge-Kutta second order method. And the reason why I'm asking you to repeat the example using Runge-Kutta second order methods with the same step size, this was h equal to 3, is to see that whether you're getting better solutions by using Runge-Kutta second order method as opposed to using the Euler's method, which was shown in this example. And that is the end of this segment.